comes, here comes Speed Racer. He's a demon on wheels. He's a demon and he's gonna be chasing after someone. He's gaining on you, so you better look alive. He's busy revving up the powerful Mach 5. And when the odds are against him and there's dangerous work to do, bet your life's eraser, see it through. Go Speed Racer, go Speed Racer, go Speed Racer, go! He's up and flying as he guns a car around the track. He's jamming down the pedal like he's never coming back. Adventure's waiting just ahead. Go Speed Racer, go Speed Racer, go Speed Racer, go!
Stand by, ladies and gentlemen. The race is about to start. Drivers, stand by for the signal. On your marks, get ready.
It seems strange, Speed, to see you up here in the stands instead of in the race.
It'll be a good opportunity for me to watch the other drivers.
Go!
Driving the cars.
Spook cars, keep racing straight to the castle of Dr. Crippet. Another bad accident, eh?
We're going to be late for the theater.
We better take a taxi.
Taxi? Huh. It's completely empty. We're pursuing a speeding taxi cab. Hester, don't try!
There's nobody driving them. Empty.
Metropolitan Police Headquarters.
Every car from the exorbitant garage was driven away, but nobody was behind the wheels? That's impossible, you hear, and there's nothing funny about it. Hold on a minute. Metropolitan Police. A police car went over a cliff while pursuing a taxi with nobody behind the wheel? So far, we've gotten reports that 48,000 cars have disappeared with nobody driving them. Chief, there's only one person I know who might be able to get to the bottom of this.
Who?
It's Speed Racer.
Very well. Put him on the job.
I'll turn the whole case over to him.
You know, Speed, at the rate all those cars have been disappearing, pretty soon there won't be any left on the road.
Don't worry, Trixie. I'll find out who's behind it and put a stop to it.
You're regular Sherlock Holmes.
What do you say, Chim Chim? Why don't we solve the mystery before Speed does and surprise him?
All right.
We'll hide in the truck and watch what goes on. Come on this way. Now, while we're hidden, let's hope that somebody steals the truck.
Too far away. I've got to find it. I wonder where it might have gone.
There are no other roads here, so it must have taken this one.
Excuse me, did you see a strange car pass here?
Strange car?
There was nobody behind the wheel.
What's that? Nobody was driving? Very funny.
That's peculiar. It must have passed by this spot.
Are you implying that I'm lying to you about the car?
No, of course not. But tell me something, sir. Aren't you the famous automotive engineer, Dr. J.D. Crepit?
Dr. Crepit? Never heard of him.
I'm sure that was Dr. Crepit.
But what would he be doing way out here in the country?
I don't know. All I do know is that he retired a few years ago and lives in a sort of castle somewhere.
The famous Mach 5. Soon that will disappear, too.
We're moving, Chim Chim. Somebody must have jumped into the front of the truck. I wonder who it could be. There's nobody behind the wheel, but somebody's driving us.
It's no use. We can't find that empty car. Might as well give up for today.
Nobody was behind the wheel of that truck. Quick, Speed. Maybe you can catch it.
Hang on. And Chim Chim. What are you doing here?
I'll tell you later, Speed. First, catch that truck.
All right, get in.
What's that funny-looking building over there?
Oh.
Thank you.
did you pull away like that?
The car started by itself.
Look, the gear shift's moving.
Trixie, the Mach 5's been put under remote control of some kind. We're helpless.
Oh, no. Speed, what will we do?
There's nothing we can do. I'd better do something or we'll be melted.
I can't bear to look. Hurry, Speed.
I can't find the remote control unit. What's this? This must be what's controlling the Mach 5, but I can't reach it.
Chim Chim, try to get it. Go ahead, Chim Chim. Reach for it, quick. Come on, rip it off. Hurry.
Grab it, Chim Chim. We're counting on you. We're getting closer to the furnace. Grab it, Chim Chim. Quick.
We're almost there.
Hang on. Thanks, Chim Chim. You saved us. You did a great job.
I'm proud of you, Chim Chim.
Who'd expect to find a field of flowers in a place like this? It's mighty peculiar.
They're certainly beautiful. I'd love to pick some, Speed.
We'd better get out of here. The blades aren't cutting. Why not?
I'm going to find out. A tree's made of some kind of metal.
Metal?
Mm-hmm.
How can a tree be metal?
I'm going to check all those flowers. The flowers are made of metal also.
Huh? No kidding. Hard as it is to believe, it's obvious that everything in this whole place must be made of metal.
Let's look around. Oh, it's really amazing, Speed. Look at the metal deer.
Wow, sounds rusty. It needs some oil.
Oh, what a pretty little squirrel. Come on, Trixie. Oh.
Let me hold it a minute, Trixie. What is it, Chim Chim? What's the matter? Oh, it's Chim Chim made of metal.
The castle's so big and beautiful. Oh, I want to look through it.
Be careful, Trixie. We don't know what's inside that castle. It might be a trap.
Don't worry, Speed. It's much too beautiful to be anything dangerous. I'm not afraid.
I'd better keep an eye on Trixie.
Wow, how will we get inside?
Careful.
It's an amusement park.
But it looks so weird. There's no one there. Almost hit.
Here comes the roller coaster.
Doctor.
Huh?
Ah!
Oh! Phew, I think I got them all now.
No, you did not get them all. I just decided to give you a break.
Dr. Crepit. Oh.
A giant. He must be as big as the sky.
No, Sprightly, he's using a projector to flash a picture of himself.
Speed!
Yes?
It's too bad that you came here to my castle, because now you know far too much about me. I'm sure you'll go straight to the police, but that can't be allowed.
Dr. Crepit, why does a great man like you smash cars? What's the reason? Why have you caused the police so much trouble?
The metal from those smashed cars has been remolded and used to build my castle and everything else around here. I've turned those ugly cars into objects of beauty.
But, Doctor, you haven't answered me yet. Why have you done what you've done?
Because I hate cars, and for a very good reason. I'm getting my revenge against them. I lost my wife when she was hit by a car, and my son was crippled ever since then. I've been a lonely old man, and I hate cars. I want to destroy every one of them so they won't cause any more accidents. The world managed all right before cars were invented, and I'm sure that now people can manage to get by without them again. Anyway, I hate cars, and I hate those who drive them. And so I hate you, and I'll destroy you. I'll make every car and driver pay for my son being hurt by a car.
No, don't, no. Don't hurt anyone, Papa.
I want revenge for what happened to your mother and you. Revenge.
Papa, please stop.
Get away.
Oh, he's operating the remote controls from there.
Speed, more planes.
If we can smash the remote controller, we'll stop the attack. That gives me an idea.
Papa, stop fighting. Please, stop fighting. Please, Papa, no more. No, no. Papa, put it down. Papa. Wait. Please don't hit him. Please, he didn't realize what he was doing.
Son, you're standing.
Oh, so I am. Papa, my legs are all right. I can walk after all. I'm perfectly all right, Papa.
He was able to walk all along, Doctor. You're the one who kept him in that chair all of the time. You were unable to forgive that driver for what happened years ago, and so you kept your eyes shut to reality, and your son paid for that.
Oh, forgive me, my son.
Come along, Dr. Crepit.
All right, Inspector. Goodbye. Take care of our home while I'm away.
I will.
We'll keep an eye on the boy, Dr. Crepit. He'll be in good hands, so you won't have to worry about him.
Thank you. Be a good boy while I pay for my crimes, and someday I'll be home again.
Oh, Papa.
Now stop crying. Goodbye, son.
Goodbye. Papa!
Stop crying. It won't do any good. And anyway, you have a lot of work to do, starting right now.
Work? What do you mean?
Preparing the castle and the amusement park to be a place where children from all over can come and enjoy themselves. You've got to get rid of the metal flowers and plant real ones. Throw away the big metal trees and make real ones grow. Turn this place into a place of natural beauty. It'll be a lot of work, but it'll be worth it.
I can see where I just won't be able to sit by. I want to help. Me too, and Chim Chim.
You know, Papa is going to be very proud.
Don't miss the next exciting episode of Speed Racer.
Go to Speed Racer, go to Speed Racer, go to Speed Racer, go!